Hey everyone, this is Richard.
And this is Linda.
Welcome to the Day Zero Gamer Infinite Live Show. This is show number 115 for January 26th, 2014. So I was in a Batman mood this past week. Ooh. Sat down, watched a ton of episodes from the Batman animated series.
Very nice.
Mm-hmm. I've seen it like maybe 2-3 times, you know, in its entirety.
Mm-hmm.
But I love that show. Absolutely love it. So I just popped it in, you know, while I was eating and stuff. And then after I was done, I just sat down and kept watching more.
Kind of like chips. You can't have just one.
Yeah. Yeah, one episode didn't do it. So I just had to keep watching more and more and more.
That's
so, yeah.
Awesome.
I love that show. So.
Cool. For me, this past week, I was talking with a friend, and he mentioned a quote from Robin Hood. So I basically spent the week watching Robin Hood Men in Tights about like 3 or 4 times.
Nice. I love that movie.
It's so funny. And it has some of the best quotes.
The Sheriff of Rottingham is like
he
my
is
favorite character.
He is the best, yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, he has the right look and attitude, but I love that he just says everything messed up.
Yeah, the way... When he's delivering the bad news in a good way, that's like one of my favorite parts too. Just the way he delivers his lines is it's
and
just
he
so
keeps
awesome.
Such a straight face.
Yeah.
Like he's so serious.
Mm-hmm.
Love that. Yep.
Yeah, that show's awesome.
That was the highlight.
Nice. Very nice. So what is on the agenda for this next week?
Tuesday, January 28th, Dragon Ball Z, Battle of Z comes out for the 360 and PS3. Tomb Raider Game of the Year Edition comes out for the 360 and PS3. And Tomb Raider Definitive Edition comes out for the Xbox One and the PS4. And that's all I have to report for this week.
Nice. Okay. So on to what we've been playing. So I've been rocking some Call of Duty Ghosts.
Mm-hmm.
Some more of The Legend of Zelda Phantom Hourglass. Making some really good progress with that game.
We're almost at the end of January.
I know,
you
I know.
You need to finish one game at least.
Mm-hmm. I don't think it's going to be this game. I've been working on it, but I don't think so. But let me go ahead and say I played Borderlands 2 and Super Mario 3D World. And that's the game, Super Mario 3D World, that I believe I'm going to beat. Because I'm really, really, really close. So.
You have 1 week.
I know. So hopefully by the next time we talk... I can say, yes, I completed Super Mario 3D World, and it'd be awesome if I could beat Zelda, too, but we'll see. But anyway, that's what I've been playing.
Awesome.
How about you?
I've been playing some Call of Duty Ghosts.
Nice.
Having some fun there. Borderlands 2, co-op with you, of course.
Mm-hmm.
And I have to say, this past week, I have had a renewed passion for Animal Crossing New Leaf.
Oh, wow.
So... I had to take my car in for maintenance, and I brought my 3DS with me because I knew I was going to wait a while. I ended up playing Animal Crossing New Leaf for about 2.5 hours.
Wow.
And after I got my car, I drove home and played for another like 4 hours. And Thursday, I took my 3DS, went and found a Nintendo Zone location,
mm-hmm.
and got myself the tea set.
Nice.
And then I went out again Friday with my 3DS to get the slushy machine.
Oh.
Yeah. So when I logged back in, I had a letter from Nintendo saying that for this date to this date, they're giving this away. And so I was like, oh my gosh, I have to get all this. So yeah, I kind of went a little Animal Crossing crazy.
Very nice.
Renewed passion is always
yeah.
good.
Yeah. Awesome.
And that's all I played this week.
Alrighty. Well, that is good stuff. Okay. Well, let's talk some news. So Killzone Shadowfall is going to see clan support arrive in early February. So that is pretty nifty. It's going to be an excellent addition for those that would like to form clans and participate like that. And a new title update is available for Dead Rising 3.
Ooh.
It's crazy. This thing is 13 gigs worth of updates, fixes, and basically prep work for the first DLC story edition.
13 gigs
is bananas. I cannot honestly think of another game that's had a patch. I mean, 13 gigs? That's a lot.
That's like the game.
Yeah, I know. Seriously, that that is a massive amount. So anyway, some of those fixes include stability and performance adjustments, achievement fixes, smart glass tweaking, and a bunch more stuff. So yeah, it's one of those things where if you want to continue playing Dead Rising 3, especially online co-op and stuff like that, you got to have it.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the news.
Awesome.
So instead of the retro game, we're going to kick off a new segment. And we'll be doing this from time to time. It's called Justify Your Game. Now, what is Justify Your Game? Basically, we chat about a game, try to justify why we like it. And one of us is usually going to take points. So that person's going to essentially justify the game they pick and just kind of talk about it. So I am going to justify none other than Call of Duty Ghosts.
Woohoo.
Yes. Now, for those that have been listening to the show, you know, for any kind of extended period of time, you should probably know by now that I am the Halo guy. I like Call of Duty. I enjoy it. But Halo is my first-person shooter of choice. So it's a little strange, if you think about it, that I'm going to be justifying Call of Duty Ghosts. The reason is because I really, really, really like this game. And I actually had to justify this to three of my friends this past week. And all three of them ended up buying the game. It's kind of funny because I felt like a military recruiter, if you will. You know, fits because of the theme. So anyway, let's talk about it. Now, I got to say this too. I got to preempt this by saying this is my opinion. It's not necessarily the opinion of Day Zero Gamer, of course, you, Linda, even though you love Call of Duty, or anyone else. I mean, even you guys. So I have to say that right here and right now, so that way I don't have to keep covering my butt as I say something, because this is, again, this is all for me. This is me trying to justify this game. Good? Got it?
Yes.
Okay. I had to take a deep breath. And I exhaled it all, so now I have to take another one.
What?
Because this is intense. I mean, I'm talking about a franchise here. I mean, Halo. Okay, let me just go right into it. So Halo versus Call of Duty. I love Halo for tons and tons of different reasons. But one reason is because it's really balanced. Mm-hmm. And I say that because it's balanced in the sense, and I've mentioned this before, where everybody starts off, you're on the same ground, you're even, you have the same weapons. Weapons are on the map, so you go pick them up and stuff. But really, everybody is the same. It's not like anything is locked, right?
Mm-hmm.
So then Call of Duty, though, Call of Duty does it differently. It always has. And that's that whole progression system where you have certain guns, you unlock others, kill streaks, you know, all that stuff. So it's a different kind of first-person shooter. And so, again, I've always preferred the Halo style. Now, that said, I'm not saying it's like Halo, but it's a full package. And by that, I'm talking about what it offers. It takes like a bunch of the best parts from past Call of Duty games, improvements, and it has its own unique things, puts it all inside one single game. And again, I'm talking, look who I'm talking to. I'm talking to you, Linda, who, of course, you know what I'm talking about. But so before I tackle the multiplayer part, I want to go over some of the other standout things that really, really made Ghost that full package, like I said. So it has a single player campaign. It's filled with those cinematic moments. I mean, that's really, really big for Call of Duty. Extinction. This is huge for me because it's literally a completely separate mode. It has its own level, so you level up and stuff. It's completely separate from the multiplayer levels. It has its own mechanics. It takes elements from the zombies, you know, from the Black Ops series and from World at War, which is great. I mean, you can purchase guns on the maps, but it's different. It's the point A to point B, Left 4 Dead style, and there's a goal. So I really, really like that because that zombies mode was great, but after a while, you kind of, well, it's the same thing over and over and over. And so this one, it's totally, it's like revitalized. I mean, they took that formula, that zombies formula, and totally improved upon it. So I think that's great. Plus, you can play with up to four people. Then we move over to Safeguard. Safeguard is so freaking awesome. And here's why. Because it's a survival mode, which Modern Warfare 3 had. I mean, Modern Warfare 3 had that pretty awesome survival mode, you know, with different maps and stuff. But this one's different because the whole flow of the game. I mean, you spawn with a pistol. You cannot pick up enemy weapons. You have to wait for the loot rounds and the support drops. It's a different survival mode. And so for people that have Modern Warfare 3, there's no reason that you can't have both. I mean, there's a reason to play the Modern Warfare 3 version and then this one and back and forth. I mean, they're different enough that both can coexist in your collection, I guess. From there, I have to say the bots. This game is awesome because it has bot support. And that's a big deal. That's a big deal because it's not every day that we get a game that has bots in it, let alone really, really awesome AI. I mean, this game has it where the intelligence and the way they're coded, it's lifelike. I mean, if you didn't tell me and I didn't know any better, I swear I'd be thinking I was playing with other people.
Yes. That's one of my favorite aspects of that.
Yeah. Now, Black Ops had bots and stuff like that, but this game, they decided to give you like a triple threat. And so here's what I mean. So you have bots via other player squads, which the difficulty, the map, the mode, they're all decided by the owner of that squad. So that's pretty interesting because if you challenge another squad or if you get into the matchmaking in a way, you have no control over that. You have no idea what the difficulty is going to be, which map, which mode, of course, what arsenal they have and stuff. Really challenging. So I think that's awesome. And then you have another one where it's the squads. It's still under squads, but it's just the AI. So you set the difficulty, the host does, but the map, the modes, the enemies, they're all random. So you don't have control over that. Then the third way that you can fight against bots is offline, which is awesome. I'm really glad that they have that in here. You can choose a number of bots on your own team, the other team, the difficulty, the map, the mode, even, you know, of course, the weapons. Everything's unlocked. So essentially, you can really practice, hone your skills, and you have complete control over everything.
Mm-hmm. It's a great training.
Yeah, training. Excellent. Really excellent. The fact that they give you three different ways to join with the bots, plus what's great is you can do it with another player. Or yes. In the case of squads, you can do it with several other players.
Mm-hmm.
So there we go. So there's four great things right now. And I haven't even touched really on multiplayer. I mean, bots, yes, that kind of crosses over. But let's talk about multiplayer. This is the whole thing where I opened up with Halo and stuff like that. And the reason why I like this game so much, apart from all the content, and again, this is that full package. There's tons of stuff. But it's the multiplayer. This is the first Call of Duty game that I can actually honestly say that it made me, and I'm going to be very careful on how I say this, it made me want to stop playing Halo to play this. And again, that's no disrespect to Halo. I love Halo. You know that. Everybody should know that. Mm-hmm. I love Halo. But to tear me away from Halo is pretty tough because I love that game. I love the way it is. And I'll do that. I'll stop playing Halo. I mean, in the past, I've played Modern Warfare 3. I played Black Ops 2 and stuff. But it's usually just for a time, you know, or with certain people. I have found myself sitting here playing Ghost by myself. Like, not just once, not twice. I'm talking for weeks at a time. When I'm, as I'm listing off these games I'm playing each week, a lot of the time I'm playing Ghost by myself. Just because I'm having such a great time with it. And that's really where it is. It's the multiplayer. So this is the first Call of Duty that I can honestly say is balanced. Now, again, I understand everybody has their opinion. I said it. This is mine. And I'm sure people would disagree with that, but let me explain why. When I was justifying this game to those three other people, two of them, their biggest problems with Call of Duty is the feeling that when you're a new player, if you don't pick this up day one, you start joining these games and you're severely, super, super disadvantaged.
Mm-hmm.
You got these guys who bought it day one, have been playing like crazy, got all the good guns. They're over there killing everybody because they have the great stuff. Then they get kill streaks. They get rewarded for that. And they're just dominating the battlefield. And it's very frustrating being a new player. And it's almost overwhelming that, geez, can I even contend with these guys? So that's always been the problem. And Ghost does it completely different. Ghost has a currency system that allows you to buy weapons, attachments, perks, kill streaks. Everything can be purchased.
Mm-hmm.
In Black Ops 2, the last game, they had kind of a similar thing where you could purchase all these different things with the points. The difference, though, is that in Black Ops 2, it was still locked by level. So I couldn't purchase the shock darts. Remember those things?
Yep.
Yeah, I couldn't purchase those.
My favorite.
I thought it was awesome, but I couldn't get those until I was a certain level.
Mm-hmm.
So even though I had the points saved up, I was still stuck. I mean, it was essentially the same old Call of Duty formula, except now it has a currency system. So you... realistically, you don't have to unlock everything. You just buy what you want when you're the right level. So it did work. But again, it's that same problem that if you're not a certain level, you can't have it.
Mm-hmm.
This game, though, Ghosts, nothing's locked by level. So what's really awesome is that if you want to, provided you have the cash or, well, the squad points, you can purchase just about anything right away. And that extends, again, to the weapons, attachments, the kill streaks, the perks. And the perks is really cool because the perks will automatically unlock once you reach a certain level, but you can purchase them early. Simple as that. Now, here's the crazy part. Again, somebody that has no idea about ghosts and doesn't understand has been following what I'm saying. Wait a minute. That still requires me to be a level one, to play online against people, get beaten up and stuff like that, to earn the points, to buy that stuff. And here is where that balance comes into play. It's extremely flexible because you don't have to do that. You can go ahead and go to the bots against other player squads, bots against the AI, you know, the first two I talked about. You can play those completely without any other people, and you'll earn squad points. You'll also level up. So this gives somebody who is a level one, who doesn't really want to play against people, or is just wants to focus on, hey, I'm going to play against the AI on super easy. It's just going to take me a while, but I'm going to do that. I'm going to get enough points to get what I want, and then boom. At least I have stuff. At least I have the guns I want, and I don't have to really deal with somebody just totally rocking the battlefield. So I think that's fantastic because it gives people that flexibility, that choice, that option. Also, what I think is really fantastic is that there is the weighted perk system. And you touched
on
this.
That's my favorite.
Yeah, you touched on this in your review.
Yes.
It's an element of Black Ops 2, really. Each perk has a different value, and so you have a certain amount of slots and you try to fill them up, you know? And yep. This perk may be 3 points. This one's one. This one's two. This one's five. And you have to manage as many of those perks as you can inside of that restriction.
Mm-hmm.
It's excellent. But what's really cool, too, is if you're a person that doesn't want to use a secondary gun, or if you're willing to give that up, or if you're willing to give up a grenade or two, you can actually have another two or three or whatever, how many things you give up, slots for those perks. And then you can have more perks to kind of compensate for lacking of the secondary gun.
As of right now, I have 7 perks on my main loadout.
See, that's excellent to me.
Because most of the perks I like using are very low in value.
Mm-hmm.
So it works out great for me because I can like literally load up my loadout.
Yeah. The fact that you have that flexibility, that option, I mean, it's excellent that you
that
have.
That makes it so nice for me because I can really configure my guys with how I play.
Mm-hmm.
And that helps me out a lot.
Yes. And that's one of the things where, again, I'm talking about balance. If you want some more perks, that's fine, but you have to give something up for it.
Yep.
It's great. Great system. Now, I also want to say this, and this is something that I thought was fantastic. When you first create your own guy, you have a choice and a chance to unlock an entire class, if you will. So you have several to pick from, and when you choose it, it unlocks that weapon. And unlocks a set of perks, and that's stuff that you don't have to buy. That's just a great feature because none of these weapons really, to me at least, feel like they're, oh, these are level one guns.
Mm-hmm.
They all feel like the end game guns from past Call of Duties. Like, I think of Black Ops 1. I worked my butt off to get the Commando. Remember
mm-hmm.
that gun?
Yes, I do.
I worked so hard to get that. That was the last gun for me. That was the end game gun. And I finally got it. And it was like, this is awesome. I have it, and I'm just tearing people up. It was great. And then, you know, the friends I was playing with, they moved on to a different game. And it was like, darn, you know, I worked so hard for it. It would have been great if I could have had this gun from the beginning and enjoyed my entire time, that whatever amount of months, enjoying that gun, enjoying the game with the gun that I wanted. So for this game, what happened is I picked the assault class. I got the SA-805. Great gun. Excellent gun.
Mm-hmm.
Found out that I really liked the Honey Badger. And instantly, I had like a flashback to the Commando because that's kind of how it feels. It's like that end game gun. But here I am. Right away, I have this gun. So I wanted to throw that out there because you also have the choice to purchase other squad members. And every time you buy one, you have a choice to pick one of the classes again. And that's just so fantastic. That's such a great system because it allows you to get these weapons and these perks where even at day one, without earning any of these squad points, you have a complete set. You have an excellent gun, you have some great perks, and you're ready to go ahead and fight those people that have been playing for a year. Well, at this point, it hasn't been a year. It's been a couple months. But you have these people who have been playing this every single day, and here you are, a level one. It's not like you're at a disadvantage. You have really great stuff, and everybody else has that stuff. It's awesome. Now, the last thing I want to say, and I think this is probably one of the coolest things that they did, it's the prestige system.
Mm-hmm, yes.
Now, in past games, I've never wanted to prestige. In fact, I've reached max level in Black Ops and Modern Warfare 3, and I intentionally didn't prestige. I know you do, and tons of people do, but I didn't. Now, I know why they do that, I mean, it's a total incentive to keep playing. It's one of those things where you start over, you get that thrill of going through the ranks again. It's fun. It's an excellent thing. But there are cons to it. There are downsides to it.
Yes, definitely.
Obviously, the downside of, well, my stuff's all gone. That sucks. What if you're in a clan? What if you're in a clan and it's like, okay, guys, let's go ahead and play. Well, now, sorry, guys, I have prestige. I don't have all my stuff. Well, that kind of sucks. What if you want to play with some of your friends? Oh, man, that sucks. You know, I'd be doing so much better, guys, if I had my guns back. Sucks I prestiged last night, so sorry. I mean, I wish I'd be doing better, but I'm back at level one again. That's kind of a frustrating situation. So the question would come up where, how can they keep that thrill, that wonderful feeling of, okay, I'm starting over again, I have that sense of accomplishment again, the goals, but I don't lose all my stuff. It's very hard trying to come up with a solution for that. But these guys did it. Mm-hmm. And what did they do? They came up with the squad system. And so what you can do is you can have the first guy you pick, you get to max rank, whatever you want to do, prestige technically, but you don't lose all your stuff. Mm-hmm. At any given point in time, you can pick another squad member. You can purchase them for 3 squad points. Some of the other ones are more expensive. And then from that point, you can go ahead and start leveling that person up. So you can actually be leveling up your main guy and at a moment's notice, swap over and start leveling up the other person. And then do it again and again and again. So you can be juggling all of your squad members at one time. And at any second, on any day, you can go ahead and go over to your best guy and be prepped and ready to play as competitive as you want. It's genius. Absolutely yes. Genius.
I really like that because I always hesitate to prestige. But when you reach max level, I mean, what are you going to do? I'm going to continue playing, so I might as well prestige and start leveling up again because I'm going to be playing again anyway. And lucky for me, the guns I usually like are unlocked pretty early on.
Mm-hmm.
So I get my guns back pretty quick. It's just some of the perks and equipment. That's sure. The frustrating part because I have some of my favorite ones that don't unlock until much later. But I don't have to worry about that. And if I move on to level up another person, I can switch back to my main squad member anytime I want.
Yep. So, I mean, as a whole, just kind of wrap this up in a way. For those that have maybe tried Call of Duty and were a little put off or a little frustrated by, oh, man, it just feels really, really unbalanced. It feels unfair. Give Ghosts a try. And it'd be really easy to look at Ghosts and at face value to be like, oh, it's the same old thing. But there are so many improvements that they made. So many really great additions that truly make this a much better game, in my opinion, than all the others. Now, granted, it had to build upon the formula and the things that these other games did. I mean, I'm talking about this game brings back the Modern Warfare 3 killstreak system. So you have a choice. You have 3 different options. You have 3 different choices there. Do you want the ones that are just like before, where you got to get 3 or 4 or 5, whatever, before you die? They have the one that goes even through death. The support package, it's a defensive one, but you can still earn it even though you die. I mean, it gives you those options. It's great. They brought stuff back from the other games that really worked, fixed, in my opinion, things that didn't work or improved upon them, and then crafted this extremely great multiplayer that is truly balanced, that is great for people that are just showing up day one, but also rewards people that have been playing because you can keep prestiging if you want. But in a way, it's really more competitive because everybody has that choice to be as good as everybody else. I mean, it does take skill, but you're not better because of the equipment you have, because only you have it, or only a certain amount of people have it. Everybody can have it if they want. Then, of course, I mean, they gave you the gender options. You can customize your guy the way he looks or she looks. Just tons of stuff. I think this game is fantastic. So, yes, for those that have not played Call of Duty Ghosts, but maybe you're on the fence, give it a try. Check it out. Look into it. And even if you just want to sit there and play against the bots, it's going to feel like real people.
Yes. The AI is incredible.
It's great. So there we go. There's my justification of Call of Duty Ghosts.
Very nice. I think that is a good spot to wrap things up.
I think so, too.
We wanted to thank everyone who took the time to listen to the show. Be on the lookout next Sunday for show number 116. Special thanks to Ronald Jenkins for providing Disorganized Fun for the Infinite Lives Show theme song.
Have a great week, guys.